la música de Harry Fry.
Game day. It's time to get it. Let's go. It's Weber game day, baby. Let's get ready.
For those who don't know, my name is Griffin Andrews and I play Weber basketball instead of for my high school team. Shit, look at this, way too much. Weber pretty much is just rec league basketball, but it's way more than rec league basketball for now. It's a lifestyle. It's something you gotta grind for, you know? You can't just be successful in that league doing nothing. You gotta work hard. You gotta wake up at 1 p.m. every day like this. You gotta come out ready to face the toughest competition. You gotta come out ready to get fouled in every which way possible. You gotta get ready to come out and play against the best defenses that a team can throw on you. You know, they gotta know your reputation. They gotta know my reputation out there. Today we play against Andrew Viola. I don't know if you guys know him from the channel. He's terrible. And I hope he sees this video so he knows how bad he is. I'm known around the league for bringing out some heat with the socks. I'm known as a sock god. Like, look at these. I haven't worn these yet. These just fell. I haven't worn these yet. Today I think I'm going to go with the AI socks. Allen Iverson on the sock, you know. Gotta keep it fresh, gotta bring out a new pair of socks every game. Gotta keep them guessing, you know. Like to lay out my jersey before games. And you know I'm all about the accessories too, so I gotta find my accessories. Going with the gray sleeve today. I haven't worn this gray sleeve since the second or third game of the year. Put it on the left arm over there. That's actually my right arm. Sorry. Put it on the left arm over here. And then I've been doing well with these. These are my signature leggings right here. Now the inside out right now. Nike Pro Combat. All gray heat gear leggings, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I'll just fix these whenever I have to put them on. No, before each game, I like to go through my closet, go through my drawers, see what accessories I could use. For each game, I like to bring out new socks for each game, as I said before. You know, bring out the heat for each game. Can only wear socks once ever, and then I can't wear them again. I've been rocking the gray leggings for the past few games because I've been doing well in those. But before that, I was rocking some black knee pad legging type things. I wasn't doing very well in those. They weren't very comfortable, so they're kind of like my little side accessory. And I change up the sleeve every game too. I go between the gray and the black Nike, and one time for one rotation I wore a headband. But to go, or before each game, I like to just, you know, see what I'm feeling each day and then wear that. Just gotta eat lunch, you know, get ready for lunch. Oh, look at this. This is my boy Zach Thick over here. This is my guy, Zach Thick right here. Guy. Number one fan right
this
here.
This is so unexpected. Griff is such a great guy. I met him a while back, about an hour ago, and from what I've learned, he's one of those guys that change your life. I mean, before, I was about to drop out of school, gonna move to the Kansas, gonna become a farmer, but I met Griff, and now I'm a billionaire.
So right now I'm eating lunch. My mom served some nice chicken parm bread. Stuffed bread. It's from Fratelli's. Shout out.
In Minnesota.
In Nebraska. Ah! Come here. I got a dog too. You want to see my dog? He's my dog. His name's Coco. No reference to cocaine though. So yeah, you know, you always gotta eat a balanced breakfast, lunch, whatever. You gotta stay full. Time to go work out a little bit before the game, you know, get a little pump. Welcome to the basement, aka the weight room, or the clubhouse. You know, I got a little basketball court down here. You know, I just like to grind down here. This is where I get better. Right here is where I get better. Look at this. I can barely even touch this weight. Okay, this is like 350,000 pounds in one bar. Just to get my legs pumped a little bit. It's more of an informal deadlift type thing. Just put any weight on the ground. I'm going kind of light today. I mean, I can only go up to 45 ever, but I'm only going to do a few reps. And what I do is just get in like a deadlift thing. Oh, I'm pretty sore, damn. And then just lift it a lot of times. Usually I do 20 of them in a set. But it's game day, so I'm doing 3 of them. All right, next, very lightweight for these. These are my shoulder exercises. You got to do these for pitching, and you got to do these to play basketball, so you always stay in shape. I just thumbs up on the weights. These are only 8-pound weights. Got to go light, and then just go up and down. Then you go to Ys, and then you go to Ts. I don't know if I have room. Got room? And then just stretch out a little bit. You can also get down here. Just go in a circular motion. But I don't really need to do that today because I'm not pitching. So just these.
So what's your max?
My max bench?
Yeah.
Infinity.
Do you always bench?
Nah, I mean, it's not my top priority. But I like to do it sometimes because I like to build my chest. Chest got to be kind of strong.
What do you got on right now? What? The bench.
What am I going to bench right now?
What's on the weights?
This is for, not sure who was doing this, but put it down there, and right now I'm going to go, I guess. Actually, let me show you another leg exercise quick, because that's the most important thing to do.
Okay.
So lay like this. It's only if you have one of these machines. And then, you know, get like this. This really works on the hamstrings and the calves. And you just get lift. Mostly the hamstrings. Just doing those for a while the other day, but I'm not gonna do those right now. How much weight should I bench?
Infinity.
So I'll go with the bar. And instead of just the bar, I'll add some weight. What's a good weight to just do?
95.
This isn't even triple digits. It's probably the weakest bench I've ever done in my entire life. So it's only 95.
Wait!
It's a very weak weight, as you just heard. But, you know, I'm not really trying to get big right now. I'm just trying to get loose, you know? You gotta get loose before games. You can't be sore during the game. So, you know, just get ready. Just bang them out. And then just do that 100 times. And then pretty much you're ready to play basketball. So it's 2:22 p.m. right now. I'm leaving the house in about 2.5 hours because my game starts about 6. So right now is when I'd probably start to stretch and all the sore muscles that I have, I'd get them out with this here foam roller. You know, it's a tradition to always use foam rollers before any athletic activity at high school. And that's why I put on this sweatshirt, because it's currently like 10 degrees outside, and that's what I gotta go shoot around with. So first, my hamstrings are the most sore thing in my body right now. So what I do is put the hamstrings on the foam roller like so, if you can see it, and just go back and forth on it. I got my game socks on. Always gotta get ready in the game socks. Right, and then I'm gonna focus on the inside of my leg a little bit. Roll it, just a little bit. Roll it back and forth on the inside of my leg. Quads. You just gotta reverse it. Lay with your quads on the foam roller. And kind of just roll back and forth like you did with the hamstrings. And then I just like to get into some regular stretches without the foam roller. Just like reach down. I'm the least flexible person in the entire world, so I can barely touch my toes. You might be the least flexible.
I am.
I can barely touch my toes on a good day. Like that. That's just stretching out my hamstring. Like I said, they're sore. Then just rock back and forth a little bit, stretch out the quad. Do that on both sides. Then focus on the upper half a little bit. My shoulder's sore. And, you know, just do some static stretches like this and get ready to ball. So yeah, we're playing Andrew Viola's team today. Should be a pretty easy game, very winnable game. But no matter what, before games, I like to go outside and shoot around a little bit, get the momentum flowing. You know, if I start to make my shots out there, I know I'm going to start to make them the game too. It's always a good rhythm to get into by starting to shoot early rather than late. So, pre-game, you know, you always got to come out here and get some shots up, you know. Always got to be working on something. All the snow still on the ground from the snowstorm we had. It's currently 16 degrees out or something like that. But you still got to come out and shoot around a little bit before each game.
I always go out and shoot around. You know, the one game I didn't, I actually was the only game I didn't score in double digits this season. I only had 9, and most of them were on free throws. Pretty bad game. You know, you always got to get out there and start early.
So that shoot around didn't go as I planned. It's really cold outside, and it's hard to get a consistent amount of shots. When it's that cold, my hands are freezing. And the wind was blowing a ball away, but I didn't make too many of my shots out there. So hopefully when I get inside of the gym, it's really warm in that gym. Hopefully I can get inside and get in the groove, start early and start making my shots early when I get there. So now I like to just sit down a little bit before I have to leave and watch some highlights of some of my favorite players, some people I want to model my game after, and especially today, since I'm wearing the Allen Iverson socks. I gotta watch Allen Iverson highlights because I might want to model my game after him today. A couple flashy passes, getting close to dunking, but not really dunking. You know, even though he's like 3 inches smaller than me, I'd like to be like him today.
So, where are we right now?
It's my hometown, baby. It's Wallingford, Montana, Connecticut, New York, or Virginia, or Nebraska. Know wherever I'm from. I gotta love this city, baby. You gotta love this town, city, town, village, whatever you wanna call it. It's the place that brought me to the world. I grew up here. Look at these houses, projects. Look at that blue house. Fire damage everywhere. This is where I came up. The people in this town, the people that taught me everything I'll need to know. You know, this place is famous for almost nothing. You know, anyone that comes out of here has a chance to put this place on the map. So that's what I'm trying to do with my life. I'm trying to put Wallingford on the map. I'm trying to make sure everyone knows where Wallingford is and who Wallingford raises, because Wallingford raises champions. We're entering the other side of town right now. We're entering Lyman Hall. Lyman Hall side of town. You know, this is where some of the kids we play today are from, so there's a pretty big rivalry. Straight out of that fact, I like this side of town. Before games, I like to come in here, come in the hardwood, just dribble this ball around a little bit, you know, so you get a feel for the ball. And then, because this is the ball we use in games sometimes, so to have this at my house before games is a pretty big advantage for me. So I can dribble around and lose it sometimes. My main job is ball handling, so then I also like to see if I can palm it to slip it. And today I have a dilemma, actually. Since it's almost time to go, it's 4:42 and I gotta go at about 5. I got a dilemma here. These are the shoes. That I've been wearing to every game so far. Under Armour, high top, clutch fit, black to white fade. I've worn these every game so far. But I might want to change it up for today just because. I might change it up to the LeBron 11 Gamma Blue. But I don't know what I should do, so. What should I do? I'll figure that out right now.
What should he do?
Yeah, let's ask Zach. Yeah, that's my guy, Zach. Hey, it's my brother, Zach, right here. He's a shoe expert. And we're gonna ask him what we should do with this shoe dilemma. Should I wear the clutch fit?
Mm-hmm.
Or should I wear the Gamma Blue, the bronze?
Clutch fit? Yeah.
I should keep it consistent.
You should keep it consistent.
I'm gonna keep it consistent. That's what we're gonna do today with shoes.
It's all about comfort when you're balling.
So it's time to leave now. 4:55, gotta head up, gotta go pick up JT. There's a door behind you, boss. Yeah, I gotta head out now. I'm all decked out, ready to ball. You know, it's like 16 degrees out. It's time to drive, it's time to get up there, it's time to win this game.
Keep the whip.
I'll tangle up here. So I'm on my way to the game now. I had some Twitter beef earlier that I was just checking out. One of the players on their team tweeted me telling me to get ready to step up, you know. So I gotta bring it my all, gotta give it my all tonight. Bring everything I got. I got a big crowd coming. Shout out to Mark DeVince, who will be there for his first Weber game I think he's ever seen in his entire life, other than the ones he's played in back in eighth grade. But we're close to the gym now. Now's the time where I start to get in my zone and the time where I start to listen to music, you know. Usually I'll be sitting there listening to music before the game, getting in the zone, not talking to many people except for probably everybody. I'll be talking to most people. Here, finally. It's game time, baby. It's game time.
Small chance.
I had a chance, but I was too tired. We played AV. And AV, I don't know if anyone's standing down there talking to his coach.
I don't freaking know where he is.
You can't see
him? I
zoom in. All right, don't do that.
All right. Are we playing here?
And now we're just going to chill out and
Any snack machines?
There's snack machines. I don't know if we'll go there.
All right, if you pay.
I will not.
So he had a pretty solid performance today. I think he had 18, a couple blocks, large amount
many
of rebounds.
Blocks. Didn't dunk.
Maybe had a couple double. But ended out quite the ass whooping. Could that be said on YouTube?
That's my life check.
We're done.
He was first born January 21st, 1998. He was long as fuck. He's only grown a couple inches since then.
Yeah. We won by like 30.
Want to say words about
no.
me?
Say words yeah. about him.
You gotta say something.
Film a documentary. Say something.
Fucking documentary over Weber.